I feel very excited and also very nervous because what I've learned over the years is that the audience finishes the film and the film is not done until it's gone to the widest possible audience. They complete it, they tell you what it is, they define that experience.
You are the man who gave them the power to destroy themselves and the world is not prepared.
I want to ask you about that Cillian Murphy from almost 20 years ago in Batman Begins.
Yeah.
And how do you see yourself nowadays?
Older. I feel really privileged to have worked with Chris for this long. I mean, he's changed my life creatively and professionally. I've learned more from him than I have from any other director, and I feel very proud to have been in 6 of his films.
There's another experiment going on behind the scenes, using the IMAX format. Usually, you use that to show panoramic views, big things. But for this movie, you're using that to film psychology.
Well, my director of photography, Hoyte van Hoytema, and myself, we've worked with the IMAX format for years, mostly for action, for spectacle, as you point out. And for this film, we knew that it would give us the desert landscapes. But what Hoyte and myself became interested in was, can that tool help us to climb inside his head? I wanted to tell the story through Cillian Murphy's eyes, playing Oppenheimer. And what we found is that the IMAX format is equally immersive and radical when it comes to intimate situations.
You had to arrive on set every day with a precise and specific knowledge. So what can you tell me about your experience on working with this mentality?
It really is all about the director. And in our case, the director was also the writer. And so the script was so good. His notes are great. So after you do a take, he'll come up and give you something very specific and simple to make an adjustment. It feels effortless working with a director who's that good.
Everyone wants to impress Chris. Everyone just wants to make him happy. It's like
Papa,
making dad.
Can you hear
Papa,
me?
Can you hear me? It's like trying to make dad really happy.
The practical effects. How did you feel about that? Like talking specifically about the bump.
Chris believes strongly in practical effects. I mean, all the films that I've ever done with him, there's never been a green screen once. You know, he believes that the performer responds to the environment and you get a truer performance. And I think he's right. For this explosion, he wanted the horror of it and the kind of beauty of it to feel real. And you're only going to get that with practical effects.
What can you tell me about having Christopher Nolan's evolution after making these movies and getting in this one as a bigger filmmaker?
You try and take on the stories when you feel ready, when you feel that you have the necessary skills to tell the story. There are all kinds of things in my work today that lead me to this place. And then very specifically with Tenet, there is a reference to Oppenheimer. It was a realization for me as I finished that film that really that film is about the yearning or the desire for there to be some way to uninvent something awful that's been invented. And in finishing that film and dealing with the reality that obviously that's not possible in the real world, then let's look at the story that inspired that fear in me in the first place, or that desire in me in the first place.